Alrighty guys, this is me, the almighty D Daragon from YouTube, and yes, 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 you see it. Now, I haven't pre-ordered the game yet, but I kind of do intend to. And I probably like, Daragon, you know how much shit you talked about Destiny in the coming months and the download content release and after you beat it? Well, to be honest, I never really explored the actual expansions till lately. Now, why did I do that? Well, because I heard that once you hit year one, you hit level 30 or you own both expansions. One, I thought it actually meant you had to hit level 30 and buy the expansions, but it's either or. So I didn't know that, unfortunately, but you get exclusive content for doing that. So it's coming out September 15th. It's called Year 2 with Destiny, which is cool. But it says if you are currently a level 34, you will start taking King as level 34, all right? So they have a new sword weapon called the Arc Edge. It allows you to defend using L2. Is effective against solar and void attacks, but I guess not against arc. So they have stuff like in the tower, you can select any. It'll show any item you want equipped, and it'll show it on his or her back, which I don't really understand. Now they have ghost shells, which they add more stuff, really? So you can get more glimmer based on what kind of ghost you have equipped. It'll add defense, some strength, shit like that. It'll help you find some resources, which is very nice. They have a new light system, which makes your stats actually lower, but you still deal the same amount of damage, so that's pretty cool. I guess they recalculated everything, so... But in this footage, as you see here, I honestly haven't really played that much Destiny lately, and I kind of cleaned house. I don't know how the fuck I managed to do that, but I amazed myself. You can now hold 32 quests. Apparently, quests can be turned in at any point in the game, so I guess you don't really have to go back to the tower. They have class items, which I guess you could put sashes, bonds, capes, which have, I guess, perks built into them, so I hope it's retroactive. The vault space has been doubled for weapons, armor, doubled, general items, double, well, 36 or some bullshit, which is kind of double. They have an item where when you buy it, you can get a level 25 booster item called the Spark of Light, which I'll probably do on a warlock so that I can get the achievement quite easily. I honestly do hope they add trophies in, but I don't know if they'll do that. I really do hope so. They have stuff where it's called collections, where they'll basically have a grid map of everything you've ever gotten, like in terms of exotic ships, emblems, and shaders. And if you discarded them, you could buy them back at a certain price. You kind of need legendary marks, which is a new income system, so that's kind of cool. You could pledge a faction, which you can only swap once a week, so I guess like Dead Orbit, Future War Cult, and the Monarchy or some bullshit. I think I was in the Monarchy for some reason. I don't know why I was, but I should have been in the Future War Cult. Any faction reputation gained in year one will carry over. So I honestly don't understand the point of like reputation in terms of like Cryptarch. I never noticed anything different, but now you can buy legendary stuff from the Cryptarch, which is quite cool to me. The Vanguard and Crucible marks have been replaced with legendary marks. There's no cap you can get in a week, but they do max out across, I think, I believe, 200. I guess that means you have to spend all your bullshit before the update, so I'm gonna try to do that soon, so, you know, I have everything. They have a bounty thing in rotation for certain people, in which you can do 5, and then you get a last nightfall, basically, bounty, and then you get a nightfall type weapon, so you actually don't have to play the nightfall strikes or any crazy raid shit to get good items if you just want to do it that way. Some year one exotics also have been upgraded to year two, so that's pretty cool. I don't know what the fuck that means. I hope my fucking blue raspberry or whatever it's called, purple raspberry armor, get upgraded. Be kind of disappointed. Not everything's getting upgraded to year two, which will be a piece of shit. Gunsmiths allow you to take weapons and try them out, which I guess is kind of cool. I don't know where the fuck they take you. It says gaining reputation or ranking with the gunsmith allows you to get a gun every Wednesday in the foundry section, which I guess will be a good one. And then as well as that, all the year 2 exotics and armors have an infusion ability where you can basically fuse stuff with an even more powerful gun and like a certain one, you get a boost. So I hope that means like all weapons will have a year 2 type boost, which would make me very happy. But all in all, the expansion does look like it adds a lot. I'm sorry about it being very vague, and if you hear the AC in my background, I do apologize. It's been very humid lately, but all in all, I'm quite impressed with it. I've been, honestly, I don't know why I've been playing Destiny over any other game lately. I guess I kind of got in the mood because the year 2 is coming out, but you know, I should be honestly beating games instead of going back to old ones, but I actually am having fun. I try to get a little done a day so I could get my rank up, so in time that I can spend all my shit, so I don't have to waste my money on some bullshit or just vanishes, because some stuff will be, I guess, vanished, as well as, you know, some stuff won't transfer, so that's kind of disappointing. But anyway, guys, this is me, the Almighty D. Enjoy the rest of this match. I have a few matches up. I'll probably post them if you like it, but honestly, it's my thoughts. I really do hope they fix the story in terms of Destiny, because I still don't know what the fuck's going on in that game. As well as, you know, it'd be great to finally have a decent story. Hopefully the cutscene is not taking place in a video form where you had to click it on a menu. Instead, it's actually integrated into the story. But who knows? I hope the Taken King is way better than the rest of them. I did have fun with Destiny. I still am having fun when I went back. I do apologize, guys. I talk so much shit about this game. But I flip-flop. I said Splatoon was a piece of shit. I was like, I'm never buying that game, and I ended up getting it for $40. So who am I to judge? But yeah, this is me, the Almighty D. Check out the rest of this match. It's pretty decent. I did pretty epic for not having played in a while, which is kind of funny to me.
Heavy ammo inbound. Heavy ammo available.
Really? Lying? Cheating?
Only 5 minutes left.
Bogus.
You're almost there. Fort victory, Guardian.
Again, the blind guy shooting me.